£1. Good day.
When I was 5, going on 6, the man in the long robe told me it wasn't my time yet. It was a beautiful fall day at the zoo. Sunny, calm wind. Wearing shorts and a long sleeve shirt. Leaves on the trees are starting to turn. Green, brown, orange, the yellowish tint. It smells like popcorn, cotton candy, and animals. I was running across the parking lot feeling free. Boom! I get hit by a truck, thrown in the air 10 feet, get down my head, and the truck lights completely on my mom immediately began to pray to God.
Please, God, don't take my son away.
My Aunt Jan got this freak in her strength and literally lifted the truck up with both hands as they slid me out from underneath it. And there was this warm light. Sensation cannot be felt here on Earth. It's a feeling you can't describe. It was so incredible that I didn't want to leave. Now, I'm sure you're all expecting broken bones, brain trauma, no. Not scratching my body. Why am I here? Where I'm from, no one makes it. Everyone settles for the blue-collar life. We started fucking off at 12, 13, drinking, smoking herb, and that pretty much became all that we did. Dude. I'm gonna come on by, twist one up, roast a couple bowls, get ripped. Or you wanna get a 40, maybe a ball, and get jacked as fuck. Maybe we just get some boomers. Make some mushroom tea, get that nice full body hat. I felt threat. In the neighborhood, working dead-end jobs, there was no way to get out. Now, I don't know if you smoke pot, but when you're a full-blown stoner, you're high all day, every day. And everyone has their rituals. For me, it's dumping out the ashtray. I have to have a full bottle of water and a full bag of Stonies and a bag of Bud to last all night. That way I don't have to answer my phone. I don't have to get up to get the door. Shit, I don't have to do anything for that matter. Just chill out, get that nice little warm, toasty feeling. Kick back and play some BGs. You'll melt. I'm working 40 hours a week. Not a dead end jobs for no long. Jiffy Lube, janitor, landscaping, telemarketing, mag groceries, hell, I even worked at the 7-Eleven. And then I was working at the liquor store. And the manager from this bar down the street would always come in. And I'd be like, come on, man, hook me up. I'm a good kid, just give me a shift. No shifts. I got no shifts, kid. And then one day, about Fridays, kid. Want to do Fridays? So now it's like you're the fucking man. Because when you're on that side of the bar, you're just a regular guy. You're standard fucking asshole trying to get laid. But when you're behind the bar, you're mixing the drinks. You don't even have to try. Now they tell you to have a few cocktails on the job, that way you can loosen up a little bit. And the drunks don't feel like they're drinking alone. 30 minutes into my shift, Warrior Mike comes in. I like the damn one. by the auction. You see, this way the coke dealers knew you were on their side. So they just keep you going. Anytime anyone would offer me a bumper and blast, I'd do it. Who says no to free drugs? And that's the hook, though, for them too. Because now they know you're buying yourself a saccharine after your shit. Now, I'm not saying bartending isn't a dead-end job, but now I'm making three times the money and working half the hours. My stepmom would say to me,
Billy, why don't you do something else? You need some structure in your life.
Why would I give up my 2-day shifts and work 5 days for the same money? I'd rather work 40% of the week than 100%. It made no sense. So what did I do with all that free time and extra cheddar? I was a fucking Jones. Played a shit ton of online poker, always looking for the big score. I was selling weed, playing video games, and going out every other fucking night. Wasting my days away, and not even knowing it. Never was this girl. Because there's always a girl. This girl had it all. Cutest girl. Type of girl that could go out in a hoodie, still look amazing. Now, if she wanted to be beautiful, she could be beautiful. And if she wanted to be sexy, you knew she could be sexy. She even had a cute voice, bubbly personality. She knew how to manipulate me. The girl was like a drug addict. I think that's where my problem started off, getting even worse. She liked to do it so much, now I'm doing it all the time. So I had to set rules for myself. I used to like to call them the coke rules. I could only do it on the weekends, and I can't do it back-to-back nights. That way you're only doing it one day a week. Less than 2 months? No, those rules are gone. All right, new rule. I can only do it on days that I work. Yeah, that snapped right away. Good call, Junior. Now my brother, he hated this girl. He knew what she was all about. Fuck, he still hates her. Now my brother, kid works harder than anyone I know. Just a good kid, never fucked with drugs. He's my top dog all time right there. He's 2.5 years younger than me. And we always believed in each other for everything we did. He never knew I didn't coke. I don't know how I kept it hidden from him for so long. My nickname was Bumble Stiltskin. It's a Saturday night. Things are going good. Me, this girl, all my friends throwing down, straight up fucking rage fest. You know what I mean? I decided to go to the bathroom, do myself a little blast of a Belushi, and I'm chopping it up on the windowsill. I hear the door open. I don't think anything of it. June? Now June is what my brother is. My stomach fucking drops. Oh fuck, I gotta get myself out of this fucking situation. I mean, this is it, I'm fucking busted. And it's worse than getting pimped by the cops. June? What are you doing in there? I just start wiping down coke off the window so fast as I can, coke off my hands. Ah, some scumbags just left some shit in here, I was just cleaning it up. And that was it. I was the scumbag. I was the piece of shit. I was lying to everybody, my mom and dad, even my own brother. And that was where I stopped. God thank the good Lord for that one. I said, fuck it. I'm getting my shit together. I'm turning my life around. No regrets, no goodbyes. I moved out to Colorado. I cleaned myself up, and now I'm back home, In Chicago, baby!